Ladies and gentlemen, what's going on? Welcome to episode 39 of the It's Obvious Gaming Podcast. I'm your host, Preston Pugh, and I'm joined by my two best friends, Garrett Drake.
That's me. I always forget to... I forgot we kind of slowly evolved into you addressing us, and then we say, like, hey, or what's up, guys? Or like our cool catchphrase. Like, yeah. We got to come up with cool catchphrases.
We want to look like we know what we're doing, to some extent.
Like, I could be a really cool guy. You could be like... Garrett Drake, I could be like,
that's your thing?
How cool would that be?
That is stupid.
No, I would hate myself if I did that. I'll probably just be like, hey, what's up? Or something.
And Jacob Alka.
Hey, guys. It's going to be my thing.
That's your thing.
Hey, guys.
Yeah.
You should remain that soft-spoken for the remainder of the podcast.
Okay.
Yeah.
It reminds me of AM radio.
Yeah. We pretty much radio. All sounded like that when we first started.
We did.
The podcast. With our one mic in the middle.
Yeah.
Those were the times, right?
Yeah.
That was such great memories.
Yeah, absolutely. This is the It's Obvious Gaming Podcast, the show where my two best friends and I get together every single week to discuss video games, obviously.
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 Gary, you got to stay quiet with that chair.
I typically do that at the end, but today's a special day.
It is.
As of now, it's Tuesday, February 23rd, mm-hmm. which marks the 1 year... Is it birthday? I guess we could call it the birthday.
Birthday or anniversary.
I like anniversary.
I was going to use anniversary in the title.
Okay. Our 1 year anniversary.
Yep.
As It's Obvious Gaming.
You're right.
We did it. We made it a year.
We did.
Good job.
And we've blown up. Us. This is too much for us to even handle.
You guys want to sing happy birthday to It's Obvious Gaming?
No, I would rather not
really
do that.
Happy birthday to you.
So about a year from today, or a year ago from today, we posted a video of us reviewing The Order 1886.
We did.
Yes.
You remember the exact title?
The Order 1886. Is it good?
Question mark.
Yeah. Is it good?
Is it good?
And I opened it up by going... We're obviously the best gaming channel on YouTube.
Obviously.
I thought that was going to be my thing we did.
Right.
But how wrong was I?
Hey,
we're still figuring it out. 365 days later, we're still figuring stuff out.
We've definitely progressed in a year. That's for sure.
Certainly.
We're definitely more comfortable behind the mic. Mm-hmm. Our setup as a whole, we went from one mic... to three mics, mm-hmm. to getting a new table, to getting a green screen, to getting wireless mics, to actually... Now, we don't know what we're doing, but we could trick people into thinking we kind of know what we're doing now.
Fake until you make it, am I right?
Gotcha.
Exactly. So, you know, until people actually watch our stuff, then they realize we're a bunch of morons.
Yeah.
You know.
No, we just have no idea what we're doing, but we're having fun.
We do have fun. I think that... It is pretty weird we've been doing this for a year, though.
It is. It's very...
Doesn't feel like it.
No.
I can't remember the last time other than, like, a school I've attended or a job I've had where I've committed to it for a significant period of time and considered it an achievement. But the fact that we do this on our own time with our own money to obviously acquire all the stuff we've acquired.
Obviously.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. To acquire all the gear we have now to be able to put out the quality of videos we put out, which let me state something real quick. I'm never one to just complain about mistakes, and I'm not complaining about this mistake. I just have to address it real quick. We still haven't learned to completely talk either on this podcast.
Yes.
But for those of you that watched last week's podcast, episode 38, where we discussed the Fallout DLC, let me first apologize for the terrible quality of audio you experienced because we tested our audio and it was great. We're like, all right, cool, sounds good. And as soon as we started filming, something went wrong with our interface and something miscommunicated and it just massacred all of our audio and it was gone. So, of course, when I went to edit the video, my soul was torn away just slightly. I lost another piece of my soul because it was terrible. I was like, this sucks because this is such a... It was our longest podcast ever. It was about an hour and 40 minutes long. Mm-hmm. A ton of fun news. Me and Jacob had like a really awesome conversation. We had a lot of fun and it was such a good conversation, so much fun talking about all that stuff that the hour and 40 minutes felt like 30 to me. Mm-hmm. And I was so devastated because I was so excited about that podcast and especially to talk to all you guys about that stuff. But the audio is so bad, I just felt like is almost a waste.
Yeah.
But I have to say thank you to all of you who liked the video, because I told Preston, I was like, I wouldn't be surprised if we got like 10 dislikes on this because it's so bad. But we did get a dislike, which is fine. I think we deserved it because I'm very serious about consistency, quality consistency, because if there's one thing I'm passionate about, it's audio. And I want it to be crystal clear. I want it to sound full. I want people our voices to be at an equal volume. I want to be able to listen to our podcast and not once have to think about, this sounds annoying, or this could be better, that could be better. Obviously, we could be better, yeah. But at least our quality is up to par.
It's going to really suck as if the same problem happens as we're talking about this. So
as of right now, we're good, I can tell.
As of
hopefully, we're not peaking too much. We seem kind of loud.
I was noticing good. That.
Hey,
well.
Hey.
We're good.
We fine?
Yeah.
I hope so.
We'll see.
We should be all right.
Okay, let's hope.
Yeah.
Sorry about the inconsistency and it sounding like absolute garbage.
One thing we have a learning curve to get over is ever since we got our wireless mics, they also share with the mixer that we use for our podcast, and we're constantly having to re-EQ and regain everything for those mics. So getting it back, because for a while we went on a long stretch of podcasts where we didn't touch the interface and it was very consistent.
Yeah.
And it still, with the exception of last week, sounds relatively the same.
Yeah.
But obviously figuring out the difference.
So I guess the next step would be getting a digital where we can actually
save. That'd be amazing.
You know,
and just recall it. That's there. Stuff, that'd be sweet.
That could potentially be on the horizon.
Certainly.
For its obvious gaming.
I was just talking about, I wanted to apologize for the poor audio last week. And thank you for those who liked it, because that just shows that you guys genuinely are supporters of our channel, which we greatly appreciate it. Obviously, we'll get into this more as the podcast progresses tonight. But the fact that we've only been doing this a year and we have people like you that support us the way you do so far, it's just
keep going back.
Yeah, a true honor and privilege. And we seriously, I know we say it week after week, and I promise you, we're not just blowing smoke out of our butts. We genuinely are incredibly thankful for the handful of you that consistently comment and like our videos. And even if you don't like or comment, the fact that you simply watch at least 5 to 10 seconds of our videos every week means something to us, and we greatly appreciate it. And there's a handful of people I will shout out on the podcast this evening at some point when it's appropriate that I want to thank personally, probably towards the end.
Excellent.
You guys hear that rain?
I do. If you guys hear the rain in the audio as well, I apologize. It's coming down pretty hard here in Atlanta.
I love rain.
Me too.
Sitting inside listening to it. I love going to sleep in the rain.
All the way home in this rain.
I'm sorry, Preston.
I gotta drive 5 minutes home.
Have to drive quite a long ways.
I'm glad you're here, though, because we've missed you quite a bit the last few weeks.
I've been just... It seems like every week so far, I either have to get up early the next day and it's gotten too late, or it's just a whole kerfunkle of things.
Yes. You had a date one night, didn't you?
Yes.
How'd that go?
Good. Okay. It went well.
That's good.
Yes.
Did you,
have a good time?
Yeah, have a good time.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay.
I had a good time with you, Jacob, on our videos.
We had our own kind of good time.
I'm sure
what I mean?
Did.
On this very table.
Wow. Wow. On video?
No.
You sure?
We were just making sure this table could hold a lot of weight because these mics are pretty heavy.
Just in case we fall on it.
Yeah, and this candle itself is like 300 pounds, so you know, you got to put it to the test.
Okay.
Put it through the ringer.
Okay. I'm glad you guys were looking out for the table then.
Absolutely.
Thank you. If by chance you did record it, would you have a, you know, do you have it?
I mean, I keep all my files on my computer.
Okay.
I'll take a look.
Okay.
If I find something.
If you by chance have a recording of it.
I'll throw it your way.
Okay.
Just for
review.
Just
so I can see
how
the table held up.
Exactly.
In our next quarterly meeting, I will I'll address it.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yes.
But guys.
That timing was immaculate. I'll let
you
go.
Guys. You guys have any future things you'd like to do, you know, with this channel to give the absolutely massive audience something to look forward to.
Well, let me start with this.
Mm.
I say before we talk about our plans for the future, let's first reflect on our first year.
Okay.
Let's reflect on our initial thoughts before we started. I want to reflect on what we consider our biggest achievements, some of our downfalls, some of our favorite moments, and so on and so forth, and really dig deep into this first year we shared as a YouTube channel.
Okay.
So first, I think it's appropriate to say how funny it is. Not necessarily super funny. Like, Preston and I, for example, have known each other for how many years now? It's over 15 years.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
We were in second grade.
Yeah. And so. That's been a very long time.
Yes.
So I've known Preston for a very long time. I met Jacob in technically middle school, but we were not friends. I just noticed your mullet in eighth grade, and it was awesome.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah. Jacob was very popular at school, too. I was very quiet. I didn't have a whole lot of friends, but I knew who Jacob was. And then in high school, you know, like Zach Bynum, Preston and I attended different high schools, but Jacob and I became pretty good friends throughout high schools, and including Zach and our big group of friends that we hang out with, mm-hmm. who most of you guys don't know because they're not on our videos. But we have a solid group of guys we've been friends with for a long time, mostly since high school. And the fact that after all these years, I remember for a while we saw, you know, Let's Plays and podcasts and gaming YouTube channels started to make their big appearances and start to be on the rise for a while. And we were heavily inspired by various YouTubers and various gaming individuals out there that over time really inspired us to start our own channel. And for, I remember at least a couple months, we were like, oh, I think it'd be really fun to do this. Like, we kind of have the stuff we need to do it. Not necessarily everything, but we have enough to get started.
To start out, at least.
Yeah. We had ideas on, like, how we'd want to do it and stuff and blah, 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 blah. And one thing led to another. And finally, I don't remember what initially gave us that final push.
We're just
push.
Like, let's just do it.
Yeah, I think one week we were just like, let's literally just do
we
it.
Just kept putting it off.
Uh-huh. And do you guys remember, I wanted to talk about this. Do you remember any of our other name ideas before It's Obvious Gaming?
Yeah, I do.
You do?
I think.
Because I don't remember.
I remember okay. one I really one. Liked was like Trinity.
Trinity?
Yeah, because like
Trinity Gaming.
People, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, that was taken.
Was it?
I think by a few people.
Okay.
Yeah, because I was researching that. Yeah.
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 Didn't we consider like Valiant Gaming at one point?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm not trying to plug this, but just to put this into perspective, Preston and I are in a metal band together. We have been for years, and it's gone nowhere because we do nothing productive with it for some reason. We have a handful of solid tunes that we haven't promoted at all, but we're in a band called Among the Valiant. Preston's a guitar player. I play drums. And I used Valiant for a lot of things. For example, like my home, even though it's a very pathetic recording studio, I've utilized it a bit to record some bands. I call it Valiant. Well, I wanted to call it Valiant Engineering because I thought that sounded more professional, and I wanted to include like photography and video stuff as well, and kind of like a big multimedia type studio. And I had to rename it to Valiant Studios because a band I recorded recently needed my contact info for this album they were putting out. And they're like, Valiant Engineering is confusing people. Can we call it Valiant Studios? I was like, sure. But anyway, I remember considering like, why don't we call it Valiant Gaming? Because it's just, yeah, I don't know. Why not? Because it's like a cool word, I guess. But we were like, no. And do you remember any other ones we tried?
I think those were the two big ones that we were kind of like okay about.
Right.
But
we were trying to plug in like three in some way.
Yeah.
Three of us.
Like
three
I remember, didn't we at some point as a joke call it like Just Three Boys or something from Tim and Eric?
Yeah.
Like we might have joked about that at one point. Just Three Boys
for, like,
Gaming.
Three dudes. Or
so stupid. It's like we're just trying so hard to make the three work, and
I wish it would have worked, but
yeah. I mean, it's funny. I think of not necessarily for us, but band names, for example. I think of band names all the time. And I'm like, I wish we would have named a band this or that back in the past. But tell the story as to how we came to deciding on It's Obvious Gaming as the title. It's
like,
pretty
might
hilarious.
Not be the most exciting.
Yeah,
it's not.
It's not exciting, but it's funny.
I was just like doing something like cleaning up my room, and my mom walked in and was like asking me like, "What are you doing tonight?" And I was like, well, we're trying to do this podcast thing. She doesn't even know what a podcast is, so I was telling her what it is, and she's like, oh, well, that sounds cool.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, yeah, but we can't come up with a name. And she just goes, it's obvious.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay. She was like, yeah, it's obvious. I was like, why are you saying that? She's like, because it's obvious.
What?
Yeah.
I was like, okay. And then I like got in the car, and I was driving to your house, and I was like, It's Obvious Gaming.
Yeah.
It's like, that actually sounds okay.
Uh-huh.
So I called you and was like, it's obvious. And you were like, what?
I was like, what is, man?
Yeah. So that's kind of how it happened. My mom, I literally said, I don't know what to call it. My mom said it within like 5 seconds. So it's like, all right.
That's so funny.
Sounds
so
cool.
You've heard it here, folks. Historical fact of the evening is that It's Obvious Gaming was conceived, essentially the title was conceived by Preston's mother.
Yeah.
So,
and then I contacted a friend of mine, not a close friend by any means, but an acquaintance of mine, who does graphic design. He makes absolutely like stuff that is just nuts.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, I got $40, dude.
Yeah.
Just do something. And he made our logo for us.
And there it lay.
There it is.
Yep.
And I made our like icons. I like photoshopped and took assets from this and made it into stuff and like made our borders and everything for all our videos and stuff. I was just like, what's the font, dude? He told me what it was, and I just started, you know, going off of that, which yeah, I mean, that's exactly what I told him. I was like, I want something simple, and I like red and black, so
yeah. I still to this day really like that logo a lot.
Yeah, it's a cool logo.
It's very like it's very simple, and I like the colors. Yeah. So it works for me.
I like simple stuff. I me don't too. Like, you know, I just, that's exactly what I told him to do, and he did it in like couple hours. Paid the man $40 and went on my way. So, but yeah, that's pretty much, not that anybody was even asking, but that's the story of It's Obvious Gaming.
Didn't we kind of play with the colors at the start of the new year?
We didn't change any colors, but for example, we had a lot of white in our
I didn't mean like literally
stuff.
Change the colors, but like mess around with like the ordering and
right
where we put the colors.
Yeah, we wanted when the new year rolled around, we wanted to kind of take on a different look just to mix things up a bit, because I'm also a fan of YouTubers I've kept up with like for well over a few years that will every now and then switch it up a bit and very subtly switch it up to where visually it just keeps things interesting.
Like I think for instance if you've been, you know, following us for a while, which I don't know if there's really anybody that's followed us since the beginning.
Right.
It might be. If you are, let us know.
Uh-huh.
But like, you can definitely see the progression of our clip art to our borders to our intros and stuff.
What are those little pictures called?
Thumbnails?
Yeah, thumbnails. I love our thumbnails.
I keep saying clip art, but thumbnails is something it. I like, you know, I made, I think, like 3 or 4 borders that we kind of progressed through, and now I was like, you know what? Nobody can really tell by looking at our videos besides reading the title if this is a podcast, if this is a Let's Play. So I think once I moved into like, all right, let's make it very evident that... Because I forgot what video it was, but I think people were having a misconception that if this was a podcast as opposed to a Let's Play about a game we were talking about. So I was like, I'm just going to completely...
Make it obvious
now. Exactly. So that's kind of, we did that.
It's very organized.
And when
now.
The new year... Yeah. Now when the new year started... you were like, let's do a new intro thing, and you made it look cool with the bouncing thing and stuff. So yeah, we're in the intro is a little bit different and stuff, which we might get a new intro and stuff. I've talked to a few people about doing it, but nobody I've tried to contract about 2 or 3 guys to make us like a really cool intro, but nobody's really understanding what I want, and I don't know what we want really. I mean, it's like so fast. I don't want like a dubstepy intro where it's like flying across the screen. I just want it fast. Like me and you made the jingle in
like in 30
literally
minutes.
30 minutes. Yeah. Like is whatever. Just like, you know, scale going up or something. Just you know, we made like a NES sounding like tone. Well, now it's not, but you know, initially in the beginning we did. But yeah, I mean, that's kind of like our progression up until this point. And like I said previously, obviously the quality of our stuff has gotten better. So we've, you know, just us as, you know, entertainers per se, if that's what we are, you know, and our equipment, obviously. Right. But yeah, I just hope to kind of progress this year.
Right.
Do that. Yeah, I mean, that's all we can really do is just get better.
You can only go up from here.
Yeah.
Certainly. Unless we can just come crashing down.
Yeah, unless our audio just wants to just not work ever.
That'd be terrible.
So hopefully that's not the case.
You guys remember when we wanted to make a commercial? And like
our trailer?
Yeah.
That's probably still in our best interest to do that. I feel like we could make that pretty funny.
We could probably just make one like out of our old content. Just the best moments, you know?
Yeah.
Some funny moments.
I don't know. I think we could do something cool.
We have the means to do so now. We have like no excuse anymore.
All that cool stuff. We actually have a really nice camera that we can never use in our videos because it can't record that long.
Right.
So we could actually use that. I don't know.
That camera's such a tease.
Yeah, it is a tease for sure.
It looks beautiful though, for sure. We've done like 1 or 2 videos with it that have looked really nice, but it's always just such a stress editing it.
Yeah.
But what's something I wanted to discuss that was relevant? We were talking about intros.
Well, actually... Technically our first video we posted was like our fourth one we did.
Right.
You remember that?
Uh-huh.
We did like 2 practice
runs. Yeah, that's
runs,
what I was getting to.
And that
that's
was
what I was
just
getting to.
The funniest thing ever.
Okay, so yeah, let me tell this story a bit. So our first Let's Play ever, which still to this day it is, was Towerfall Ascension. and the first Tower Fall Ascension on our YouTube channel is not, in fact, the first video we ever did. So our first video consisted of me, Jacob, Preston, and Zach, who, if you've kept up with us for a while, he's mostly on our Star Wars podcast. Zach's been around a few times. We did Tower Fall Ascension, and our first video ever, we were like, we've been watching YouTubers and stuff, guys. We have to, like, try to be more, like, charismatic than we normally are in real life. Like, we have to, like, go out of our way to be...
We have to make a lot of jokes.
Yeah, we have to be engaging and stuff. And then another problem was we were doing it in my other room originally. And I remember my mom works night shift at a hospital. She has essentially my entire life. And every Sunday for my entire life, or various other days, but in recent years it's been on Sunday, she has to sleep all Sunday because Sunday night she works all night. So during the day, my mom's sleeping, and we wanted to film this video and be loud and stuff. And we started out loud. My mom's like, "You guys are being too loud. I really got to sleep." We're like, all right. So we did our entire first video, literally like, "Hey guys, welcome to It's Obvious Gaming. We're doing Tower Fall Ascension. What's up? What's up? I'm Garrett. This is Preston. What's up, guys?" Like, what's up? We were like just talking so quietly, and every time we'd get a kill, we'd be like, "Oh, I got you. You suck." Like, we didn't raise our voices that much higher the entire video. I remember editing the video, and we were just like kind of watched it together. I was like, "This sucks so much." So... I can't remember how we got away with it with our original Tower Fall Ascension game, but it's one thing I wanted to discuss, which I think is hilarious, how our first few videos, probably at least our first couple of weeks, we are acting so stupid.
I know.
That's the thing. We still act stupid, but we've, over time, evolved into literally being ourselves behind the camera, on camera, because originally we were like, we have to like become characters of ourselves. We don't want to, because I feel like in real life we're too boring. But ultimately, something I wanted to say I'm very proud of is that all of us got comfortable in front of the camera to a point where literally the past at least few months, probably since like the summer, what you see is what you get. I mean, we're not pretending to be anyone. We're not trying to we don't try to make jokes for the sake of being funny. We don't talk about certain things to cause issues or cause controversy. Like, literally what you see is what you get. And I think the most proud thing I have, or the most pride I feel about our YouTube channel between the three of us, is that we started out as our goals and passion, our ultimate goal is literally, originally we were like, we want to start a channel where obviously the three of us or more of our friends can come together every single week and play games, because we love playing games, playing together, which rarely did that ever happen ever.
Right.
In recent years, when we would actually be in the same room playing games together. That was the first thing. We want to be able to play games together. Obviously, we love podcasts. We wanted to be able to talk about games together. And not only just talk about all this stuff and experience this stuff together, but we literally have a passion for creating some sort of a community with you guys and building an audience that we can share all of our gaming experiences with. Because the three of us, it's one thing. We literally communicate every single day. That's cool and all. But whenever you guys leave comments, we genuinely get excited about it. We're like, awesome. Because I literally love when you guys comment, especially if it's an opinion on a game or game suggestions. Because there's been various games that I would have never played if you guys hadn't told me to play it, or told me like, oh, this game's awesome, you should give it a try. And whenever we share those conversations, it's awesome. What's cool is that our first year, although we're still very small, we've grown in significant ways, I think. Mm-hmm. Not only as individuals and the quality of our videos, but our audience, although it is also still very small, the handful of people that we communicate with every week, I think, is awesome, because we're currently doing exactly what we set out to do, just on a very small scale, which is still awesome because it's very intimate that way. And Lord willing, if it is His will, and if it's up to you guys ultimately too, if we are to go beyond that at some point, if we do ever have a very large audience, even though that's also exciting, I'll never forget our core audience that began with us. I'll always remember your names. I'll always recognize your names, and I will always appreciate all the support you guys have given us over the first year, because I think it's cool that, like, at where I began, we slowly developed into just honestly being ourselves, doing these videos, purely doing them for the enjoyment. We don't do it for money. We don't do it in the hopes of making money. We don't do it for fame or popularity. We literally do it because we enjoy hanging out with each other and we enjoy getting to know you guys, which is exciting.
If we were doing it for any of those things, we were screwed.
Right. Yeah.
We literally haven't made a dime from doing this.
No, I didn't expect to.
Right. And
I don't expect to.
That's what's cool. It's never been our goal to do that, and it never will be. I mean,
no.
It's hopefully
a good goal to set.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not saying I'd be fine with it.
Of this.
No, but it's not. But it's like, that's a very rare thing to happen for a
right.
channel. There's tons mm-hmm. of other channels like this. And like, that's why I'm very thankful for people that watch our stuff, because there are literally millions of, well, probably not millions, mm-hmm. thousands of other choices that you could, you know, partake. You know, if you watch this entire video, that's an hour out of your 24 hours that you could have watched
anything else.
That really doesn't mean a lot.
I'm just
to
honored
us
that
you
clicked
us.
On this video.
Yeah, I mean, exactly. So mm-hmm. you know, like I said, there's so much to watch on YouTube. I mean, like really good, you know, tons of good stuff. So that mm-hmm. really is flattering, and we're honored for you to sit through one of our videos.
Yep.
Yeah. I hope.
Absolutely. But yeah, like I said, whether you watch 10 seconds of a video or you watch it from start to finish, we're still so thankful for that, because that's 10 seconds of your life that you spent watching us be idiots in front of the camera playing games.
Absolutely.
So I greatly appreciate that.
And that's why I part of the money thing, like, we don't have any ads on our videos.
No.
I've turned off all the ads to our videos. I don't think we've earned the right, I think I've said this before, to put ads on our videos.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to deter somebody from coming to us, seeing our, you know, pretty low subscriber counts, and be like, you know what, I don't know if I want to sit through this 30-second ad or 5-second ad to potentially see somebody that might not be good, because, you know, they don't have a lot of subscribers, therefore not a lot of people have, you know,
you know,
blah, 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 blah. So that's why I have them off. And if we had them on, it's not worth it to me to make like 5 cents for that to potentially not have somebody, you know, sit through the ad to watch it. So,
mm-hmm.
you know, that's kind of my feelings on that.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, I was going to also, I wanted to bring up what you got, what some of your favorite moments of our first year. I'll kind of mm-hmm. name a few of mine. I think one of my first favorite moments would be waking up to do a Let's Play of Final Fantasy 15.
Oh my God.
Because that was the first day where it felt like something I wish we could do every day of our lives. Because I literally felt like we were getting up, going to work.
So early.
But the work was like so fun, and the fact that we like made coffee, it was, what's funny is that it was like noon, but we had been up till like 6 or 7 in the morning trying to figure it all out, and like figure out how we were going to do it and how the time was going to work and if we could even play the game and everything. So we were up and we slept for like 3.5 hours, and we woke up to do this video. And just for some reason, I always remember that morning as just being a really fun morning. And that was also before, this sounds so immature, but before we had our current jobs that we have. So life still felt very laid back. Like I wouldn't say I'm stressed now, but we have a lot more responsibility on our shoulders now. So that was back in a time where my work schedule was limited, and it just felt like a good old fashioned summer, and we were just waking up to like have fun and play a game together.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like I always, whenever I think of our videos, I instantly think of that specific morning.
Yeah.
And that's back when we were using our one mic classic, and our border was like a meat sandwich. It was so thick.
Back when we, because you were editing our stuff on Final Cut, what, 6 or 4?
Final Cut 4 Express.
Final Cut 4.
It wasn't
our videos were like in 4:3 format or something.
And they had like the cinematic black bars on them unintentionally and stuff.
Man.
Oh, man.
I remember I went and bought a camera.
Mm-hmm.
I spent like around $200 on a camera, which was so dumb, because that's how much I wanted this to look good. Is because with my old job, like, I was making like no money. I was so poor, and I spent like all my money on this stupid camera.
Mm-hmm.
And we would record with it, and you'd edit it, and it still had the black bars. So I'm like, okay, obviously
it's the software.
This is the software. And I remember finding out when you were using 4, and I'm like, well, what are they on now?
Two.
I was like, okay, we got to change that.
Yeah.
So I looked it up, and it was like they were having a special on Final Cut Ten and Pro 10. And it's like $300. I was like, I'm taking this stupid camera back.
Yeah, it was like $100 off.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was like, I'm taking this camera back, and we're gonna get this. And then it's like we're still using our Jacob's iPhone.
Yeah, which, I think Jacob's iPhone has worked out great so far.
It's been fine.
6 Plus has a good camera.
It does. Yeah. So I'm thankful for that.
We've pretty much upgraded every single thing but the camera, because I don't really see it.
That should probably be our next step.
Yeah, which that's upgrading that to something that we want. That's a whole nother level of. I mean, we can buy mics that sound good for reasonably priced, and we've spent, you know, not, it's not like any of this stuff is cheap, but mm-hmm. you know, that's on, I think we could add up everything we've bought and it would I don't even think it would still amount to the price of like a camera we would want.
Video
to get,
cameras
so.
Are expensive.
Yeah,
they are,
like ones that are made actually to take videos. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like you're not spending anywhere near less than a grand.
Yeah, yeah. Sorry, no doubt.
And I don't want to buy, I mean, like I just said, we don't spend a lot of money for all the other stuff. I would say probably the cheapest thing we bought were those wireless mics.
Yeah.
But we can still make them sound good.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to be cheap and have our quality suffer from it. So
exactly.
If we were going to buy a camera, I would want to jump in
exactly.
with it.
Because it's a huge investment.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
Because in the long run, we use it every single week.
Yeah.
So,
like I said, I think as of now, our camera quality by no means is, you know, setting us back
no.
at all.
Mm-mm.
So
we could always upgrade our, you know, our capture card too. We may need to do that soon at some point because we were having problems with.
Yeah, it was being funky a couple weeks ago. I was scared. I thought it was going to stop working.
Yeah, but we could probably look into that as well. We just mm-hmm. got the generic Elgato crap.
Yeah.
Well, our first Let's Play, we were recording it with straight off the PlayStation.
Oh yeah.
We were like having to sync with like, all right, I'm going to push the start button.
And
right
we can only do it exactly 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good times.
I don't even think we released that video. We didn't even release that video. We got the Elgato before that.
Yeah. I remember we did a...
or after that.
We did the Trials Evolution Let's Play. Yeah. And I think we used PlayStation for that as well, didn't we? Or is that after we got the Elgato?
I think we used PlayStation for that.
Yeah.
I don't think... Did we release those videos?
I think we did.
I thought we scrapped.
There was a handful of videos we scrapped because they were so bad.
Yeah.
Like, bad to the point where it isn't even funny to look back on. It's just like, that's true garbage.
Yeah. But I would say a lot of our videos are... I don't even like looking at them, but I guess
it's funny. They're a little uncomfortable to watch.
Yeah. If that's like one of the first videos somebody sees of us, mm-hmm. I'm just like, oh, God.
Yeah.
Why?
But what's exciting is that I love, in the long run, we can go back and watch that first video.
I love watching those videos.
And I'm just like, that's where we started.
Cringeworthy for sure.
And although we still have a long way to go as far as our ambitions are concerned, we've definitely come a very long way since the beginning.
Not that I'm saying like this is the pinnacle of you know, YouTube gaming.
Yeah.
But,
you remember what we used to do?
It's way better than it was, that's for sure.
Remember what we used to do our podcasts on? That table, we had our stools.
Yeah, those were so terribly uncomfortable.
Gosh. Then we eventually moved the stools over here and did our Let's Plays on the stools.
Uh huh.
It was awkward to me.
Yeah,
sitting on stools.
It's so many things have changed. I don't know. This is funny. I don't know if you guys have noticed. I've edited our channel description like 5 different times and changed like 1 or 2 words over a period of like.
I've never.
Like if you go back and watch our first video, there's a description, and if you go like 30 videos up, it's slightly different, and you go another 30 videos up, it's like slightly different again. Yeah. And I think I've almost got to the final description. I literally will change like a word or two or rearrange words to make it more understandable.
Yeah.
But
are you talking about like the about of our channel?
Yeah, where it says like 3 best friends, blah, 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 blah.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost complete. Okay. I'm debating on one phrase that I may or may not remove, but it's very simple, very easy to understand, and I like the way it sounds because it really perfectly describes what we do.
Mm-hmm.
But I just think it's funny how that's evolved. Just very minimally. Is it minimally a word?
Yes.
Okay.
Sure.
I may not be pronouncing it correctly.
I don't know.
It's evolved in minimal ways for a long period of time. Another one of my favorite moments, I'm sure you guys will agree, on our YouTube channel was the week we covered our E3 stuff.
That was great.
That was fun.
I think that's the most fun
I've had.
Like
I felt like we were working then.
Me too.
Yeah.
But that's the thing. I loved it.
Yeah.
It was so fun. Because
that was such a fun day.
I would literally give
anything.
Like watching
E3, like writing notes and stuff.
Yeah.
So you can remember everything.
It felt like truly living the life that we've always thought would be so cool. Even though I hear all the time it's stressful, it's hard work, it's not as glamorous as it seems working in the gaming industry, but just...
I'm not really working in the gaming industry.
No, exactly.
It's more entertainment.
That's what I mean. Yeah. I'm talking about for other people, they say those things, and then I'm like, but even though we weren't working, we got a taste of what that would kind of be like when we were like taking notes and like, obviously we still had a great time watching E3 regardless. We were taking notes and like making bullet points, and then we would be all set up. We would like watch a conference, immediately come in here and film it and talk about it, which is exciting. Immediately
in between
edit.
The conferences.
Yep, immediately upload it, which was a lot of fun because it was a taste of what it would be like
as
if we were actually there.
My favorite moment was the Bethesda
Dude, you guys were so pumped after and Bethesda won.
I remember, like, I didn't even try and say it, which I know y'all make fun of me now, yeah. But my first, like, as soon as I had my mouth, I was like, what a time to be alive.
Yeah.
What a time to be alive.
So I funny. Truly meant that. Yeah. After seeing that Fallout 4, you know, first reveal gameplay, I truly felt that way for sure.
Yeah.
Well, it's crazy to think we have played a crap ton out of that game since then. Yeah,
it is. It's Platinum. So weird. Yeah. That's one thing I was going to mention is that we had been talking about Fallout 4 since the very beginning of our YouTube channel. How pumped we were!
We had tons of topics before it was even announced. Right. Or anything. Yeah.
Yeah. And one of my favorite moments too was just finally playing that game and finally putting a video out for it. It felt like we had come full circle as far as Fallout went. Finally, which was cool. But yeah.
Fallout 4 is one of those games that is very rare. It's very rare that I play a game that I can't believe I'm playing the game.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that makes sense.
I know
but
exactly
like when
what
I finally
mean.
Sat down and I just like moved the thumbstick forward, I was like, holy crap, I'm playing Fallout 4.
Yeah.
And I think the thing that made me feel that way even more is just how, you know, they announced it and then it just came up.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't just, you know, like a drawn out process over a year or two where like, oh, it's common, it's common.
Right,
it's
and like
common.
Constant demos and
yeah.
stuff.
It was like almost just shocking, like, hey, this game was announced 6 months ago. Now I'm sitting down and playing a game that I've literally been waiting like 7 years for.
Yeah.
So it was like almost a surreal moment on a very crappy 11-inch screen in a hotel in Indiana is when I played it. But hey, I was still, you know, loving every minute of it, and I just wanted to play that game.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't care how I played it. I just wanted to play it.
I told you, my PS4 broke, and I didn't even care. I didn't even think twice. I bought a brand new PS4 to play that game. Didn't even care. We bought two copies just to play it in Indiana because our other copy had been, was it the Pip-Boy edition was being delivered to our house.
Yeah.
So I didn't even care, dude. We've been waiting so long.
What a horrible time to be out of town.
Oh, yeah. I remember when we heard the news, we thought we were going to be off. Like, just kidding. You're going to Indiana for a week. My heart sank. Yeah. I was like, you've got to be kidding
me. I knew I would figure out a way to play that game, though. Yeah. I knew it was going to happen. And our I don't want to say boss, but our kind of guy in charge of, you know, what was going on, he was completely, you know, what's the word I'm looking for?
Supportive
of us wanting to play that game.
Right.
He took us to GameStop himself.
Yeah.
And bless his heart, he doesn't know anything about games at all. Like, he walked in there and was like, oh, yeah, games. You guys hate your game and stuff.
Oh, neat.
He saw Minecraft and he was like, you can buy this Minecraft stuff? And we were like, what are you talking about? They're like, I had to make a cake for my daughter of Minecraft. I didn't know you could buy Minecraft stuff.
Yeah.
Man. Minecraft's pretty big.
Yep.
Yeah.
Good times, man.
Yeah, good times. I'll never forget that. I bought like an entire gaming laptop screen thing just to play.
Do you still have that?
Yeah. Just to play it in the car.
Right.
No, there's no use now. I literally bought it just so I could sit a screen in my lap and play Fallout 4 on our journey home from Indiana.
Right.
And I'm sure you'll use it in the future a lot.
I'm sure I'll use it, you know, during some road trips and stuff. But I had to go right back up to Indiana the next week.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the best. I know we probably talked about our job, but me and Garrett just like install a bunch of audio video stuff. So I was a tech that week of the system that we had installed the previous week. I went up there and was just the engineer on site just in case anything wrong happened. I could just
tweak
go
it
fix it.
Yeah.
So I literally sat there as the guy was tuning the PA system and stuff on my Vita, and I just would play for like 6 hours and be like, all right, Preston, I don't think I'll need you. I'll give you a call. So I'd go to my hotel room and I'd just play Fallout 4 the rest of the night. I'd wake up, go there, play Vita, come home, play Fallout 4. So that was a
getting
great,
paid to do
yeah,
it all.
Getting paid the entire time to do all that. So I essentially, the second week I'd Fallout 4, I got paid to play it. So that just made it even better.
That is
granted
awesome.
I was in a hotel room, right, but the TV was it was a nice TV they had in there, but way more ideal than using my portable one the previous week. So it was like almost a month until I could actually play that game on my own setup. I was just happy to be playing Fallout 4.
It was weird that like I was able to play that game much more at the start than you guys did.
And we've been waiting so long.
Once Preston got his time, I was gone. It was
you like platinumed it before I could even finish the game. Yeah. I was like,
my life. The second I had a few days off, I was like, all right, here we go. This is it. So
you know what one of my best memories are?
What's that?
What?
I really enjoyed playing Bloodborne on our channel.
That's been circulating in my mind a lot.
That is the when I think of us waking up early because you have to be you know, pretty in the game to even be relatively good at that. And I just remember Father Gascon just like whooping my ass.
That was great
during the entire Let's Play.
Yeah, just over and over again.
Just watch, like, I don't know, just like working together in those videos, it really like, it was fun.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Are you talking about the co-op videos?
Yeah, both the one that I was in and the one that you guys
that
did
was
with
the one
Father
me
Gascon.
And you did where you fought the blood-starved beast.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you guys did too, actually.
Great.
I forgot. Yeah.
That was pretty funny.
It was fun.
Man, that game is good.
It is.
It's such a great game.
It makes
I'm
me
so
even more
excited
for
Dark Souls 3.
Yeah.
I can't believe I platinumed that game. That is
that's
my
crazy.
That's my most
I was there
platinum.
When you platinumed it.
I know. No, you weren't.
I was on the other end of the chat.
You were there when I beat that alien creature thing, and I like lost mine. It took me like 4 hours straight fighting that dude.
Yeah. I was actually in the place where he is like in the regular game.
Yeah.
Beat him.
Yeah. That was the hardest thing I've ever done anyways.
I hated that area.
Yeah.
That swampy area.
I just said like the weirdest thing ever. I don't know what I just said.
What'd you say?
I was like, that was the hardest thing anyway.
Hardest thing anyway.
That was the hardest thing I'd like ever done in a video game.
Right.
Period.
Mm-hmm.
But I knew I was gonna beat it that night. It might have taken me till like 3 a.m. but I freaking beat that guy and I screamed when I did it too. Then I realized I had like another 3 hours ahead of me. That wasn't even it. But after doing that, I felt like I could do anything in the game. And we just did a Gravity Rush Let's Play this week where I had to fall down a tube for like 8 hours.
Mm-hmm.
So that really frustrated me when I like beat this freaking giant monster creature with half my health in this what were they called, chalice chambers or dungeons?
Chalice dungeons.
Yeah. The one where you have half health and I'm fighting this giant creature with like 8 arms and I can't freaking fall through a tube in Gravity Rush. That's frustrating. But anywho, yeah, Bloodborne is a big part of this channel to me, because I remember making some really good videos with that.
Yeah.
So
another probably my favorite podcast was definitely the Star Wars one after the movie.
The review.
Yeah.
I like that one a lot too.
I absolutely loved talking about that movie.
Me
after
too.
We saw it.
I still enjoy talking about that movie. That's something we need to take.
I think we already have is our reviews tend to do very well for the most part, do very successful on this channel. Our Witcher reviews, great, like both of them. Well, we did too, just me. I think the one with me and you probably did more. I think we just probably labeled it better. That one did great. Our Star Wars review did good. I think it's probably hit a dead a wall now. Initially releasing reviews for things fairly soon to their release dates, you know, makes sense. It gets more views because more people are looking at them, looking for them. Great. I have no idea how people find our videos.
Yeah, me too. I feel like it's buried in the abyss of YouTube.
No clue how people find them, but that's cool that they do.
Yeah.
Then we'll get the random occasional video, like our Elder Scrolls beta Let's Play, which Lord knows
how did that explode.
I don't know. That was by no means a good video at all.
It was awful.
So it's kind of embarrassing.
Where we just like got on one day and we're checking on stuff. I was like, this video has like 1,000 views. Like, what the heck?
What happened?
And we have Witcher views of like 50,000 views because I paid like a crap ton of money for ads and stuff. But it shows how that doesn't really matter because there are still no comments and stuff. So it's like,
it was ultimately just to see if it would make a difference in drawing traffic to our channel.
And it didn't.
No.
It really, so that's why we don't. That's if you're going through our videos and you see like, holy crap, these videos have lots of views.
Yeah.
That's just because I put a ton of money in ads for them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But in terms, it's probably just people are seeing them that have no interest in seeing them, so they just go away. So I guess if somebody's looking up something that has to do with that game, it might be higher on the list, but in the end, it hasn't really made a difference. It doesn't even matter, exactly. So probably won't be doing it to that extent anymore. Maybe a couple of ads here and there.
Mm-hmm.
So, but yeah.
Totally.
That's all I have to say.
I'm trying to think of anything else that really sticks out in my mind. I will say my feelings towards doing this every Sunday and sometimes during the week has not changed at all since the beginning. I remember our first Sunday, I was so pumped, and still every Sunday I'm like, all day I'm excited about doing our videos. I like the whole process of it. I like choosing what we want to discuss in the podcast. I like speculating and like discussing what we should and what we shouldn't cover. I like trying to pick what games we're going to play. I love setting up for the videos. Mm-hmm. I love the process of filming all the videos. The teardown sucks. That's my least favorite part.
Yeah. Going from Let's Plays to podcast.
Such a process.
This little space we have.
Yeah, we've been filming everything in my bedroom since the beginning. Our hopes and goals one day is to be moderately successful to the point where we can like have a set like a, almost like a studio set up just permanently dedicated mm-hmm. to our videos where we like never have to change anything. I think that'd be awesome.
That would be cool.
But like I said, I've been excited, just as excited since day one till even just today. I was like all day, I was like really excited about, we were like, oh, we'll do Gravity Rush and we'll do this mm-hmm. and we finally get to talk about our 1 year anniversary podcast, which you've been looking forward to. Mm-hmm. And I'm glad I checked on our last week's podcast because I knew it was coming up and I like couldn't remember. And we could have like completely skipped it and been like, oh yeah, by the way, last week we had been doing this for a year. Mm-hmm. But I'm glad I noticed so we could kind of reflect on everything. But like I said, I still get so pumped about it every weekend, especially when you guys talk to us and stuff. It just is even more exciting as I can look forward to hearing from you guys and your thoughts and games we've been playing and your suggestions. And I still want to say that my hope would be, and this is something we should also, I mean, we haven't even discussed this in person yet. We might as well discuss it on this podcast. What you think of community questions for our friends that keep up with us on these videos, because obviously we're like, tell us what you think of what we talked about and tell us your thoughts of this.
You mean like us asking them questions them giving us
and vice versa. Like, it'd be cool if we like, obviously we want to hear your thoughts on like whatever we're talking about, but then we could be like community question or community poll. I mean, obviously it's easier to have like a website that has like forums set up and stuff for that, but I don't think we're quite at that point yet.
I'd say the biggest problem with that is just the amount of people participating. I feel like we have five or six people, honestly.
Like I said, which is still cool. Yeah, but like I said, at some point, if we reach that point, that's stuff we'd love to implement.
So, for sure.
It's a good thought.
But I would still, even though there is only a handful of you guys and gals who keep up with us, please, if at any point you just think you'd love to hear us talk about something specific that we haven't even thought of, please let us know. Like I said, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, on our YouTube comments. You can send us messages on any of those things, comments. If you have just something you'd like to hear us talk about, please let us know, because we will, at the very least, consider it, depending on what it is.
Yeah, absolutely.
But yeah, it's been a blast. It's been just a really fun year.
So I just remember the first time doing our Let's Play, or not a Let's Play, first time making just a video in general. Mm-hmm. I kept having this feeling in the back of my head, like when your mom would come in and interrupt us or something would happen. Mm-hmm. I kept thinking, like, I have a feeling that this is, we're just going to give up because we keep hitting these road marks and we're in these roadblocks and we're just going to be like, whatever, we tried. But, and I remember the first time the video released, I was like, wow, we actually put out a freaking video. Like, I didn't even think we would be doing that. Like I said, it just seemed like it was such a hassle just to get one video out. Mm-hmm. But from then
a lot
on,
of work
just
something that might not even work out for us.
Exactly. Because, you know, like we said, we made some videos that haven't seen the light of day and we'll never see the light of day.
Right.
Probably. I'm sure they don't even exist anymore.
No, I definitely deleted them, that's for sure.
So, it was just kind of just like cool being like, hey, we're actually gonna do this. Cool.
Yeah.
So that's just been cool to me that we're actually doing that. This.
Yeah, I'm very glad also that for the most part there's definitely been some weeks where it's physically been impossible for us to put out videos, but almost every week we've put out at least one video since the start.
Yeah.
Which I think is cool, and obviously there's been a few weeks where we just couldn't do it because of work related problems.
And I don't think we necessarily should. Because I feel like our quality suffers if we're just like, hey, we got to put a Let's Play out. We have to do a Let's Play.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think we should be doing Let's Plays for games we're not interested in or you don't have a desire to do, or just come up with bullcrap topics. Like, hey, did you guys hear that Sony is trying to trademark plastic forks or something? Yeah. And we like talk about it for like 5 seconds. Yeah. Like, I think our podcasts have kind of evolved from like, we're going to do, I remember in our first episode of the podcast, we're like, this is going to be a news-based podcast.
Yeah.
It's by no means a news-based podcast. It's not even close. Yeah, we talk about news and stuff, but we talk about things that interest us. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we go off, we talk about random stuff all the time too. I wanted a podcast as a way to just talk. I like talking. I like talking about things, especially in the video game industry. Yeah. But if that bleeds into like things going on in our personal lives or just other topics and stuff, that's fine too. I want people to feel like they're our friends as well. Like they're just listening in on a conversation that we just have. And I know that's generic, like, I want us to be friends and stuff. Well, I mean, that kind of is with all YouTubers. You want to, like you were just saying, we want to create a community, a means to where we can just come talk and people can listen in on our conversations and stuff. Because I've always thought, you know, our group of friends, we've always had decent conversations. So that's why I wanted to do a podcast. I was like, hey, let's save it for, and you know, do a podcast. I always loved listening to them, so let's just freaking do it. Let's do it. So
it is like a dream of mine, just to like get on PlayStation one day and just have like 10 people that are a part of our community and like love playing games as much as we do. Mm-hmm. Like want to play games with us.
Yeah, it'd be awesome.
Because I love playing games with other people.
Me too.
Yeah. It'd be awesome to play with other friends that we've made through the channel.
Yeah, that would be great.
That would be cool.
That is a dream of mine as well.
Absolutely.
But
yeah, my goal, I think, like I was going to say, our goal for this year is I just want us to, especially in terms of Let's Play, I want to do games that we want to do, not just for the sake of making a video, because that definitely matters. And same with podcasts. Just I want to, you know, do things we, like I'm going to say for like fourth time, just things we care about, because it definitely shows, and I think it makes for better quality for people that listen to us. I would much rather listen to somebody talk about something they're passionate about as opposed to just talking about it just for the sake of talking about it. Yeah. So
totally. I don't think we necessarily need like this. We were originally doing like this 5-video-a-week thing, right? Mm-hmm. We had 3 podcast topics. We had 2 Let's Plays.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I don't necessarily think we do need that. No. Let's just make content that we want to make.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Let's not force any topics in our podcast.
Certainly.
Yeah. I agree.
And I do like the longer podcast videos.
I think I enjoy them too.
I enjoy them as well.
It makes it feel less forced and like we can only talk about this amount of time.
We went from like, I remember the just how scary it was when I'd have a topic that was supposed to be like 15-20 minutes and like 8 minutes in I'd be like, oh crap, so what are we gonna do now?
Certainly we've gotten better at, you know, talking more.
Before we've started recently, the past couple of months, I remember thinking myself, and I remember you guys have mentioned as well, like, I don't know if we can talk about that long. And I was just like, no, we're going to do it. We're just going to talk. And then we looked down, and it's like an hour and a half.
Yeah.
So we've definitely gotten better at just talking about, we're talking about topics, but, you know, we just talk.
Yeah, like last week, me and Garrett were talking about like just random stuff for like half an hour before we got into anything in this
just telling
video.
Stories and
even
stuff.
Even though the quality was horrible.
Right.
Yeah. But I don't, that's the kind of podcast I like listening to, and that's the podcast that I like putting out.
We make automobile parts for the American working man, because that's who I am, and that's who we care about.
Exactly.
But we make video game videos for all the international gamers out there, because that's who we are, and that's who we care about. That's from Tommy Boy, for those of you that don't know.
Good movie.
Mm-hmm.
One goal that I would like to set is to better market ourselves, so that more people can find us.
I think a good first step would be making that trailer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If you guys have any hilarious ideas, I'm talking to you two and our friends that keep up with us. If you guys have any ideas that you think would make for a good trailer, you're just as much a part of this channel.
I've been thinking about it.
Please let us know.
I really have been.
Yeah.
I don't have any great ideas yet, but
I sure don't. I suck.
We could sing like a ballad, the three of us, an acapella.
Okay.
That'd be pretty cool.
We could.
Okay.
Jacob, you got to be shirtless because your physique is just.
It's not that.
It's
great.
Impossible. It's an impossible physique.
It's not that great.
I'll tell you, Jacob. Sometimes I'll be. I mean this in the most sincere way possible. I'll just be looking at you. I'm like, man, that man's got a body on him. you crafted it well, my friend. And it's something I will never have, and I'm proud of you for doing so.
Never say never.
Yeah.
if you want it bad enough, you can obtain it.
That's true. I'll be totally honest, though. I don't necessarily want it, because I don't have the drive to work out consistently.
Sometimes it's hard
and
just
to eat as well.
Stay motivated.
Right.
It really is. Like, yeah. I'm not just, like, tooting the horn, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, sometimes
that's what steroids
are
for.
Going to the gym. Sometimes I hate it.
I can imagine.
I still go.
Yeah.
Just because I care about how I look, even though I probably shouldn't.
Right.
You just snort that cocaine and you get out there.
Cocaine, man.
Yeah.
That's why I know we made the right decision to start this YouTube channel, because there hasn't been a single week where I'm like, oh, I'd rather be doing something else. I'm always like, this is
awesome.
I
schedule my Sundays around this.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, like, I take it very seriously. Like, there's been multiple occasions.
You guys
are
making me sound bad because I haven't been here.
Well, I mean, you've been far more busy with work than I have, because I've, for the most part, if I have been traveling, it's not far, but you've been going like across the country essentially to work, so
and
that's a lot more stressful.
In my defense, I have to drive an hour out here and an hour back, so it's not as, you know, I'm just walking down the street.
I would say your sacrifice has been exponential over the last year. All the driving you've done just to be here on Sundays.
That's why I'd love to have a location.
I know. It'd be sweet if we were rich enough to afford like a studio or like a middle ground somewhere and just meet up at the studio and hang out for a few hours. That'd be sweet.
That could be another goal to set, even though we may not obtain it. Mm-hmm. Just to, I don't know, find a way to get another location.
If anybody wants to fund us a studio.
Because I don't want to live at my house forever. I want to move out.
Yeah, so. I think you and I have been briefly discussing that anyway, because my schedule as far as work and school goes is going to change drastically in the fall, right. But
yeah,
something we can still talk about. I was going to say, imagine how much easier this would have been if we'd still lived together like we did and when we lived in that apartment.
Yeah,
it'd have been so, so much easier, but I miss those days. They're some of my favorite times. As
I'll never forget those days.
Yeah, me, Preston, Jacob, and Zach all shared an apartment while I was going to music school, and it was, that's easily, I can say without a shadow of a doubt, the best year of my life so far.
Yeah,
it was just so awesome.
It was fun.
So
for sure,
I remember probably my like most fondest memory was watching Game of Thrones.
Yeah,
like that was
just
so
watching
fun.
Marathons of it.
I had to sleep.
I know.
Yeah, I know. You missed Preston all
had,
of it.
Forrest Preston had to go to work.
I
super
just sleep
early.
To not go to work.
Yeah, skip work and play Diablo for 12 hours.
That was the second best. No, yeah. Diablo was first best.
Okay,
that was so fun.
That was.
We got our like little dim lights. We could change the brightness.
I think I skipped work for an entire week just to play Diablo all week.
Mm-hmm.
Gosh, that job sucked. That's the only reason.
I felt for it. Every time you describe it to me, I'm like, that sounds like hell. I don't blame you for skipping.
I worked like general construction just because the company paid for my college.
Uh-huh.
So I just was like in a hellhole all week just with the oh my gosh, just the thought I could gag.
Yeah,
I could gag thinking of that freaking job.
I remember how much you hated it.
But yeah, I would literally work enough to pay rent and then I just would stop going to work for that month.
Man,
that job sucked.
That was so much fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, like Jacob was saying, we had a the chandelier in our kitchen had a dimming option, so we would wait till night and we would light candles and then we would dim the light to make it look like a tavern like lamp or something. It would be very dim and dark, and we had all three of us have our laptop set up and play Diablo for like 6 hours. Yeah. Have some tasty beverages.
Those nights made Diablo one of my favorite games of all time.
Mm-hmm. That was awesome.
Great. I love Diablo now. But yeah, and that in Game of Thrones.
Yep.
The apartment was great.
And so much Taco Bell.
It's a shame it was
so
only
much.
A year.
Yep. An abundant amount of Taco Bell. We
stock
every, in Taco
we had
Bell, basically.
But, like right by us.
Yeah. And that Taco Bell man, without a doubt, it was probably the best quality Taco Bell I've ever, consistently the best quality I've ever had.
Yeah.
It was always good. Whether it was 4 a.m. or 2 p.m, it was great.
I appreciate the Taco Bell chefs that care about their work, for sure.
Me too. And I tell you, it all comes down to the management. If you have a very not necessarily outgoing, but very, a manager that's very serious, this is totally not even worth talking about, a manager that's very serious about putting out quality food and like very serious about managing his workers and encouraging them and not putting them down and like encouraging them to work hard and blah, 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 blah. It's just amazing how much of a difference
somebody's
going
to click on our It's Obvious 1 year anniversary, skip to 55-minute mark, and we're giving advice to Taco Bell managers on how to run a successful Taco Bell.
I will say it's been mostly tradition. It's either Zaxby's or T-Bell, but 9 times out of 10, we always have a pregame meal at T-Bell before we shoot our videos. Yep. Or we'll typically do a couple Let's Plays. We're like, all right, let's go get some T-Bell and then do them and then talk about what we're going to do on the podcast and come back and do it.
We should post this
any other way.
We should post this to the Taco Bell forums. And
we could have one sponsor ever. It would be please Taco Bell. Yeah. Please sponsor us.
Just
we're begging
blast.
You. We'll do it for free. Just
Dude, Taco Bell was amazing because Jacob won his gold PS4 from Taco Bell.
Taco Bell's done us right.
Yeah.
I forgot about that.
Yeah.
Like, I forgot I even had a gold PS4.
I loved our first unboxing of the Pit Boys. That was fun.
Yeah. That was great.
Because we'd never done an unboxing.
Hey, I think our next unboxing will be the Uncharted 4 Collector's Edition if somebody doesn't steal it off my porch this time.
Yeah. Didn't you say someone stole something off your
porch? Yeah, I talked
about
it the last podcast I was on. Somebody stole a tool I had ordered, so I'm very scared of people stealing stuff from me now.
That's terrible.
I'm going to get the Overwatch Collector's Edition.
Oh, really?
It comes with like a figurine of one of the heroes. It's really cool.
I'm semi-interested in that game.
Figurine of Drake.
Drake's stupid.
Drake is cool.
No, I love Drake. I'm playing through Uncharted 3 right now.
You and me both.
It's really
excellent
fun.
Game.
Yep.
We'll have to talk about that.
I prefer the second
week.
One.
Mm-hmm.
We can have a 2v3. I know people have done it before, but I would like to have a 2v3 discussion with you gentlemen.
That sounds good to me.
What is that?
Uncharted 2 versus 3.
Oh, okay,
which one's better?
I thought you meant like two people versus
that is,
three.
That's a debate like that will rage on till the ends of time.
Yeah.
I think I already know what my choice is, but I haven't finished 3 yet, so.
Oh, well, then I know. Oh, never mind. I got you.
Yeah.
We have some good content coming up for you guys.
We do.
Yeah.
Stuff I'm very excited about.
Yeah, for sure.
And before I forget, I want to give a couple shout-outs real quick to specific individuals who I've recognized, I've talked to a lot. Who I do recognize by name now all the time, and almost in a very small way, gotten to know you, at least on a gaming perspective.
Yeah. There's like a couple guys that like comment every like video.
Mm-hmm. Turned around and I think my back just broke in half.
Are you all right?
It really hurts.
You need a massage? I don't know what I did. I almost broke my foot on our Firewatch review earlier.
That really hurt. I don't know what I did.
Well, don't hurt yourself further. I don't want you to have any back problems.
It's okay.
But now, forgive me to any of those I've left out. These are people that I remember off the top of my head that I've just recognized your name a lot for a long time, talking to you guys in our comments about stuff.
You're going to be okay, Preston?
I'm fine. That just really hurt. I don't know what that was.
I'm sorry. You're making me nervous.
You're going to be okay.
It's okay.
Okay. Can I get you anything?
It's fine.
Okay.
Thank you, though.
But these are guys who I've... and girl, who I've recognized commenting a lot on our videos. And I, like I said, we get so pumped when you guys comment because we love talking to you guys about any and all game-related topics, personal topics, whatever it might be, whatever we've been discussing or playing at the time. Mm-hmm. But I'll just, in no particular order, these are just people that I recognize by name. Are Edgar Herrera. I always enjoy talking to you. Now, I always pronounce this name incorrectly, so please forgive me, but Edgaris, and I'm going to attempt just one time to pronounce your last name, and I'm not even trying to be funny. This is me honestly trying to pronounce his last name. Edgaris, and this reminds me of like a Tekken character or something, which is cool to me. It's like a really badass name, the second name on the list.
There's two guys named Edgar?
No, well, there's Edgar... Herrera Espeño, I think is his last name. Mm-hmm. That's his full name.
Okay.
And Edgar Us is different from Edgar.
Okay.
So they're two different guys. Originally, I thought it was the same guy, and then I realized it was two different guys, and now I know that there's two of you.
Okay.
And I know which one of you it is, and every time we talk. But Edgar Us, so, I mean, I've spent too much time trying to say this.
Yes,
I'm sorry.
Are.
But
okay.
Sabaluskas? I know that's not correct, and please forgive me. But
it doesn't sound
but
correct.
Edgar Herrera and Edgar Us, Matt Hook.
Sounds like a Caucasian white man just trying to sound Matt out Hook? A word. No.
Oh, well, I am a Caucasian white man. Matt Hook, I've noticed you commenting on our videos a handful of times, and I agree. We appreciate talking to him as well. Ethan T, I gave you a shout-out on our podcast a couple weeks ago. I don't know. You may or may not have not seen it because I didn't wait. I waited till like halfway through the video, and I remembered I wanted to give you a shout-out. Yeah. But if you didn't hear that first shout-out, and maybe you haven't even listened to this podcast long enough to know.
Probably do our shout-outs like at the beginning.
Yeah, I meant to do it at the beginning.
No,
I should have.
Only the people that watch the whole things deserve this shout-out.
Yeah. But in case you missed this shout-out too, it sucks. But just know that I always see your comments. I always appreciate them. But I think your account's set up to a way. In a way where I can't like it or respond to it.
Yeah,
and I even tried sending
it. It's not linked with like Google Plus
right.
or something like that.
And I even tried sending you a message to be like, hey man, thanks for all your comments. I just want you to know that we see them and try to respond, but YouTube won't let us. So thank you so much for always commenting and liking our videos. Hooded Dude, he has great content on his YouTube channel as well.
Dude.
Yeah. Yeah, I like it. I like your videos a lot too. And thank you for supporting our channel for quite a while as well. Dan Lester has commented a handful of times. Very supportive as well. Thank you. And Alberto Cruz. That's all the gentlemen. And specifically, technically two girls now. I'll go ahead and give a shout out to Shelby. What's my problem?
It's,
we went to high school with
Coley.
Her. Yeah, Shelby Coley. Yeah, we went to high school with her, and we were friends with her brother Martin in high school.
I love her brother.
Yeah, they're great. Awesome. And thank you, Shelby, for your continued support and
thank
liking
you.
And commenting.
Thank
always
you,
enjoy
Shelby.
Talking to you as well.
He was the biggest Dallas Cowboys fan.
Yeah, he was. He was a very passionate Dallas Cowboys fan. Dude, great times in high school.
I always talked about football with him.
Mm-hmm.
That's good stuff. And he loves the Longhorns.
Yep.
Texas. Big Texas family.
Yeah. Texas. You were in Texas recently.
I was.
Mm-hmm.
Like Texas
I did not
baseball.
Like it.
Yeah, you were in like a, you said a part you didn't like.
Yeah. It didn't look like Texas.
Right.
I was expecting cowboys and horses and deserts, and I saw a bunch of crappy buildings.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Preston.
I went into the sketchiest Goodwill ever. I didn't tell you the Goodwill story.
Maybe?
Really quick Goodwill story.
Okay.
One of our coworkers ripped his pants.
Yeah.
And
which coworker?
Like SpongeBob?
Steven.
Okay.
And he didn't bring any clothes because
he was
in a different state for a week.
Yeah.
What?
So why would you do that? And he was like, I need pants. And I was like, well, I want to go like to the mall and do something.
Mm-hmm.
So let's go to the mall and get pants. For some reason, somebody had it in their head that we wanted to go to Goodwill for pants.
Yeah.
I don't know why. Because we were going to the mall.
It's kind of the mall.
Yeah, kind of. So we end up at the sketchiest Goodwill I like Goodwill. That you can find cool video games there. You find cool stuff in Goodwill. So I'm not opposed at all to going to Goodwill. But this one looked really sketchy.
Right.
So I was like, guys, I don't know about this. But we went in anyways. And it was the nastiest Goodwill ever. And we spent like 20 minutes in there, and he's looking for these pants. And then I just asked him, I was like, dude, why are we at Goodwill? And he's like, I thought you wanted to go to Goodwill. I was like, I wanted to go to the mall. And then he's like, well, why are we at Goodwill?
Who was driving?
Like, Richard.
Okay.
So he's like, Richard, why are we at Goodwill? He's like, I thought you wanted to come to Goodwill for pants. And then Paul was like, oh, why are we at Goodwill? Nobody knew why we were at Goodwill. We just went to Goodwill for some reason. So then we just left. So, yeah.
That's funny. It's like we went into that White Castle in Indiana. It was just the grossest place ever. And like, I'm not one to judge, but for some reason, all the people in this town look like the hillbillies from The Hills Have Eyes, and they look like it. I swear, I got like a couple of them looked like they're ready to kill us, and they're like they're gonna shove White Castle burgers down our throats till we suffocate, and we're gonna die horrible deaths. I was very, very scared in that White Castle, but it was all right. I've had really good White Castle, and that White Castle was not good.
Our job takes us. Kind of, that's the thing, is like we work in these very nice facilities that are paying for these sound systems we're installing that are like multi-million dollar systems for the most part, but like the area, and that's the thing, we stay in very nice hotels too, like by no means we're staying at like, you know, hotels, I mean, we're not staying at motels or anything like that. But for some reason, it's like on our way or where we have to eat is just at like the weirdest places reason.
It's always an interesting experience
Yeah, it's definitely like I was just in Mississippi and we were in the middle of nowhere and we walked into this one place and I took a picture of the door and sent it to you. It looked like the door was halfway turning into like Silent Hill. When like everything's like crawling off the walls. That's what it looked like. And I ended up not eating there because I didn't have full sanitary in there at all. But pretty sketchy places for sure.
I was going to say one thing that's relevant with our job and our YouTube channel is that even though it keeps us very busy and keeps us traveling a lot, which also makes editing and uploading videos very stressful, it has also
I've always said that I would help you with that.
Right. Jacob, there was one week where Jacob edited our videos, which he did an excellent job because I was just literally incapable of doing so. I can't remember what it was. I think it was the week where my computer broke. It's before I got my new computer. So, Jacob knocked those out. But our job, I was going to say, has provided the funds necessary to be able to afford the things we've upgraded to, like the green screen and the wireless mics.
Soundboard.
Yeah, the soundboard. What else have we gotten recently?
Table.
We've been talking about it for way too long.
This table is a real investment.
Yeah. We just need to suck it up and do it. We've been talking about buying a Wii U forever.
Yeah.
But it's busy and it's stressful.
You're able to just go buy another PlayStation.
Right, exactly. Like, that's what I was saying. It was like, even though there are times when we're working, I'm like, oh, I wish I was just at home sleeping or something. It's always worth it when we get a paycheck and I don't have to worry like when my PlayStation broke, which is so funny. And we were talking about Indiana and we came back and I finally get back from Indiana. I'm like, I can finally play Fallout. I've been waiting all week. I've played it for like 30-minute increments all week. Finally, I can play this. Turn on my PlayStation, load up the game, take about 10 steps, screen goes black, PlayStation turns off. I'm just like,
great.
What?
Is this some kind of joke?
And the great thing about our job is that I didn't even have to think about it. I'm like, I'm going to buy a new PS4, and it didn't even faze me. And just the fact that it's provided those opportunities for us, I'm very thankful for, because it's helped us in a lot of ways progress our YouTube channel to the quality we have currently. And like we said at the beginning, we're still looking to continue to upgrade that quality to the highest degree eventually.
Yeah.
But it's been a journey so far as that goes, and I've been thankful for all that.
Can we
for
shout sure. out that last person?
Yes.
Yes. recently, actually, a girl I connected with on Instagram, her YouTube channel is The Pink Glamour Eye. I apologize if I'm pronouncing that correctly as well. She puts out quality content as well, kind of on a smaller scale that we do, but she does great videos, and she's been supportive of our videos recently, and I enjoy your comments as well. If you've joined us for this podcast, thank you. And but yeah, those are just, like I said, I apologize if there's anyone that feels left out. These are the people that I've communicated most with personally, and I remember all your names. Like I said, all of you mean a lot to us, and anyone can say that. We could just be pretending to say that, but I genuinely mean that from the bottom of my heart. Thank you so much for all of your continued support, your comments. Anytime you've liked a video, anytime you've watched a video, like I said, whether it's 5 seconds, whether it's 30 minutes, we greatly appreciate it. And it's literally you guys that have kept us moving forward. Because if we had done a year of videos and didn't have any comments or anything, like, who knows where we would be right now. But you guys have kept pushing us forward, and it's your support that has has gotten us to this point. And I know it's the most generic thing to say, like, we're nothing without our followers. Like, we literally are nothing without you, because we would have felt like there's no purpose to this. I mean, as much fun as we have doing this together, it's honestly you guys that have helped us make it this far. So thank you very much to each and every one of you for that.
I couldn't agree more.
Thank you very much. I guess we'll wrap it up here.
Certainly.
Thank you for joining our first anniversary of the It's Obvious Gaming Podcast. Or
I'm
the
sure
It's
we will have
Gaming
another
channel,
one.
Yeah.
I'm sure.
I can only hope.
Of course, this is the show where my two best friends and myself get together every single week to discuss video games, obviously. Almost ruined that.
Yeah, that's okay.
Haven't been doing that for a year.
No.
Yeah.
Doing it for a while, though.
For a while. And I still stumble upon my words.
Mm-hmm. It's okay. It's classic us to just screw up something we're
it
saying.
It would be out of character if we didn't talk with perfect grammar.
Yeah.
But, yeah, check us out on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Mm-hmm. Leave a comment below on anything we talked about.
Mm-hmm.
Again, thank you very, very much for all the support.
Absolutely.
And we will see you guys next week.
Everyone have a good one.